Tonight from Champaign, Illinois in the State Farm Center, it's the Big Ten Men's Gymnastics Championships, night number two. As tonight, it's the six event finals, and those six medals will be headed somewhere. We'll find out who will take it home. Last night, it was crazy. The host, Illinois, led through three rotations, and then the mighty Michigan Wolverines kicked it up a notch, led by Paul Judah and the entire gang. They would come all the way back to win big. And then, of course, Fred Richard, the sophomore sensation, last year's NCAA champion in the all-around, last year's Big Ten champion, he also had an incredible comeback to win it for the second year in a row. Fred Richard, your all-around champion from last night. And good evening, everyone. Alongside Brandon Burns, I'm Dean Linke. Tonight, we head to the event finals. Last night was crazy, though.
Last night was as dramatic as you could ever ask for a team final. But tonight, it's all about bragging rights. Expect some upgraded routines and some world-class gymnastics.
Let's walk you through exactly how it will work tonight. As you take a look at it here, there'll be six events in Olympic order. 10 gymnasts qualify for each event. Athletes can qualify for multiple events. And with that, who do you have your eye on tonight here?
Well, we've got a lot of athletes to watch, but notably Fred Richard opting to sit this one out, focus on a little bit of load management, but that does not mean that there is any shortage of athletes to watch tonight. Whoa. Namely, Paul Judah. When is he not an athlete to watch? He qualified for both floor and vault in first place, and he'll have to execute perfectly again tonight if he wants to win those event titles. Then for the Illini on pommel horse, Brandon Dang will be competing the most difficult routine in the entire country. It starts from a massive 16.5, and if he can stay on, he'll be tough to catch. His teammate Ashton Anaya on the still rings looking for the three-peat, and his gymnastics keeps getting better as the years go on. Look for a world-class routine from him. Dean, we mentioned it last night, Crew Bold on any team other than Michigan would be the star athlete. This guy qualified on both parallel bars and high bar, and he has some of the most exciting gymnastics that we'll see tonight. Finally, you cannot forget about the runner-up in last night's all-around competition, Taylor Christopoulos. He'll be on four events tonight, and he has a legitimate chance to win them all.
Well done, Taylor. Now let's break down the scoring, Brandon Burns.
Well, gymnastic scores are a mix of two things, how difficult your routine is and how well you execute it. We get the difficulty by adding up the 10 most difficult skills in a gymnast's routine. Then the execution starts at a perfect 10 and judges deduct from that for any errors. We take the difficulty value, add it to what's left of the execution score, and that gives us your final score.
Must be held for at least 2 seconds. If a gymnast short holds one of
first rotation will be the floor, the horse, and the rings. Again, 10 athletes on each apparatus. The 10 highest scores, and then, like for instance, as Fred Richard elects to sit out, they go to the 11th. The 11th isn't available, they go to the 12th and so on and so forth.
That's right, and by some of those athletes who qualified and then opting out, it really gives some phenomenal opportunities to those guys who just barely missed it in the 11th, 12th, 13th position from last night. And remember, Dean, there is a lot on the line tonight. Obviously, Big Ten Championships, your priority is your team, but this is an environment where you just want to win one for yourself.
It's also worth pointing out that the order they go 1 through 10 is not necessarily how they finished last night. Some of it has to do with, for instance, athletes that are in three or four different events.
Exactly. You would certainly not want to complete a floor exercise, for example, and 30 seconds later have to get up on the rings.
That is the order of the floor. Michael Artlip, the senior from Texas, who had a 14.0 last night for the Penn State Nittany Lions.
Completed a 15.2 start value routine last night. Start value referring to if he did it perfectly, zero deductions, what would it score? And that right there is exactly what you want to do to get one of those high scores. Stick those landings. Floor exercise is all about precision on landings just like that with the back-to-back sticks. Nicely done from Michael Artlip. as you watch these landings, just a reminder, anything more than about shoulder width is an automatic 3-10th deduction. That right there is no deduction. He'll get a little deduction for the arm circle, but nothing on the landing. Yes! 2.5 dismount. He stuck 4 passes in that routine. Dean, it is very rare that your first man up hangs on all the way through to win the championship, but he's given himself a shot with landings like that.
What a nice reversal of fortune for Penn State, as last night was simply not their night. What a great start for Mr. Artlip. So now we move to the horse. Landon Blix had a 13-8 last night, the sophomore from the state of Michigan. Landon Blix, first to go on the horse.
And this is a big routine for him. He's struggled with consistency on this event the entire season. If he can go back-to-back two-hit routines, night one and event finals, it will give this Wolverine squad a lot of momentum. Big skill right there. It's a full spin. And unfortunately, just not enough momentum to bring it all the way around. Dean, we mentioned it briefly in the open. We will probably see some upgraded sets here tonight. Again, there's no real pressure for the team anymore, so you may as well throw your biggest skills. You saw him just leaning back a little too far. Wasn't quite able to get his feet over the horse without interrupting his momentum. Very clean flop sequence, we call that, whenever you spend some time on one pommel like that. Oh, struggling a little bit there. He covered it up nicely, but lost a lot of momentum on that travel. But a good finish from Landon Blix. Again, certainly not what he was looking for with that fall in the middle, but he knows what to work on heading further into the postseason.
Go see Chow, the top man. Landon's teammate, Akshay Puri from Chicago, 13-9 last night to put himself here in the top 10.
From Michigan, Akshay Puri.
And the Puri family with a rich history with Michigan men's gymnastics. Both brothers on the team, both brothers in the rings final this evening, and a third, the former program manager for Michigan men's gymnastics. Akshay opens up with a difficult opening sequence here. Uprise to a planche, lower down into the Maltese, and that is beautiful. He left no doubt in the judges' minds. That was a full 2-second hold. Let's see if he does it again. He is really exaggerating those strength holds, which is exactly what you want to do. 2 full seconds is the requirement in order to avoid deduction. Great control there in the handstand. Small bobble covered it up well. Talk a lot about sticks tonight. I would bet that the winner will stick Akshay. Unfortunately, small hop on the landing. Remember, even though that was just a 1/10 hop, it is a 2/10 swing because he does not get the bonus. But look at the control in that planche. You hear the Michigan bullpen behind him shouting, he's a freshman. Great things in store for this young man's future.
So we go back to the floor where we can tell you Penn State's Michael Artlip had a 14.225. This is Chase Mondi from Nebraska. He's also a freshman from Lawrence, Kansas.
You see that 14.225 from Artlip for the first man out. That is a fantastic score. Chase is capable of beating it, especially with landings like that. That was a beautiful full twisting double layout. Called a full out because he does the full twist and a second flip. Oh, and he had to scramble to stay on his feet.
Mondi had a 13.85 last night.
already you can see in that second and third pass a little bit more hoppy than what we saw from Artlip. A few steps on landings, and it might not look like much, but those are the things that add up in such a competitive event final like this. Connection 2.5 to a front layout. We'll see quite a few athletes perform that pass tonight. Just the dismount. Oh, and unfortunately put his hands down there. Looked like he was trying for the stick. You never really want to try and stick your dismount. You want to try and do a good dismount and just let the stick happen. Otherwise, you may end up under-rotating like that. This is a full twisting double back. And just keeps his chest down a little bit too low, which you want to do to stick, but if you go too far, you end up putting those hands down.
Chase's teammate, Nathan York, a sophomore from Springfield, Illinois, is next to go. He had a 13-6 last night. As you see, already in the score to beat, Landon Blix, 12-3-7-5.
And he's more than capable of putting over a point on that score. He has some very intricate one pommel work. You'll see it come up relatively early on in the routine. Beautiful full spin. That's the full kier. More and more guys doing that skill. And that's what we're talking about right there. Intricate one pommel flop work. There is just so little room for your hands to fit on those pommel handles. And if you have even the most minor mistake, there's no way to save it.
Remember, Nebraska shared the regular season title with Illinois.
Oh, and that's a big break. Did not quite make it to the handstand. He will not receive credit for that dismount. He will take the 1 point fall and must repeat the element. And you see his wrist almost give out on him. That left wrist folded under him just a little bit. Was not quite able to support himself up to the handstand. Dean, sometimes in event finals like this, it's really a competition of survival of the fittest. It's who does not fall, especially on an event like Pommel Horse.
There's Chuck Chmielka. Was a great gymnast at Nebraska, part of several national championship teams. Now we move back to Michigan. Chris Reed, ninth in the NCAA, had a 13-9-5-0 last night. See his teammate Akshay in with his score already. A 13-8-2-5. That's the number to beat.
And Dean, we talked about the rich history of the Purry brothers in Michigan gymnastics. But Chris is a very similar story. His brother James was also a ring man for the Wolverines. Talked to Chris a little bit before the competition. He said, going right after Akshay, this feels like an inter-squad. Takes the pressure off a little bit. And that's a beautifully done back uprise to a Maltese position. Whenever you see athletes swinging up into a strength position like that, the idea is to go directly to the position. You don't want to go above it and settle down into the strength hold. You want to go directly to it.
York score in at 12-7 on the horse.
If Chris can get a stick here, he might overtake it from his teammate, and he does. Full and a half, twisting double back with no hesitation on the landing. Chris Reed should be your new leader on still rings. Here's that dismount one more time. Full and a half twist. He leaves his head over his shoulder a little bit to spot the floor, and he's fired up over that one.
Little flex coming from Chris Reed. move back over to the Lionize. Tate Costa, 13-7-5 last night. He's a sophomore from Rhode Island.
And Dean, this is a really cool moment for this young man. Last year, he was riding his bicycle on campus, got hit by a bus, crushed his legs, took him out of the lineup for most of the season. And here he is a year later in a floor lineup of all things. Showing nice strength and flexibility there. As a reminder, every athlete must complete one non-acrobatic skill on the floor exercise. A little bobble right there. The judges don't start counting until you get all the way up to a handstand. He held that just a little shy of the handstand. Judges should give credit, but that will be a deduction. Oh, and the power squat there. If you squat lower than 90 degrees, it's an automatic 5/10 deduction. If they feel like you bounced off the floor, it could be more. That's a tough dismount to stick, though. Front double full at the end of a routine, blind landing. Great recovery at the end from Tate Costa. Here's another look. You see him over-rotate that first skill, and that is close. Definitely 5/10 off for the squat, but I don't think I would count that as a fall. We'll see what the judges say.
Connor Miklas with the number to beat, 12-7 from Nathan York, will represent the Illini. He is a sophomore from Chesapeake, Virginia. Had a 13-8 last night to qualify for the event championships. Welcome everyone to the State Farm Center. All of you watching women's lacrosse. This is day two of the Big Ten Men's Gymnastics Championships, the sixth event championships. Last night here, the Michigan Wolverines won their 21st team title and fourth in a row. And their super sophomore Fred Richard won the all-around title for the second time in as many years. We are just getting rolling. This is the third of 10 on the horse, and obviously Connor Miklas having a good time. Alongside Brandon Burns, I'm Dean Linke. And Brandon, as we welcome everybody in from the women's lacrosse match, the excitement will build right as they look at the number. They know what they've got to do to win a title.
Absolutely, and this is one of the most fun nights in all of men's gymnastics. These guys are out here competing, not necessarily for their team, but as individuals, throwing their biggest skills, their toughest routines, to see who is the top dog on each event. I love this ending sequence from Miklos here. Unfortunate with two falls earlier in the routine, so this will certainly not be in contention for the podium, but beautiful ending to that routine nonetheless, and so much potential moving forward in the postseason.
Sam Phillips had a 13-8 last night. Sam Phillips, a fixture every year. A senior from Woodland Hills, California. He told me this is his last year. He is not coming back next year.
And his strategy on this event is to be as clean as possible, just like that, right to the position. No hesitation there. That was a beautiful backup rise, iron cross. But he does not have the highest start value on this event, starting from around a 14.7. So to be competitive with Chris Reed's 14.1, it would require him to have 6/10 or less in deduction in the entire routine. Wobble in that handstand. You want to see him keep those arms straight. Big dismount, double twisting, double back. Nicely done from Sam Phillips. I don't think it will be enough, to overtake Chris Reed, but a great showing, something to be proud of nonetheless. Let's take a look at this dismount. Do his feet slide, or does he get the stick? Two flips, two twists. That's a stick. And Dean, just as a reminder, when you get that stuck dismount, you do get an extra bonus 10th added on to your score.
Next up on floor,
Evan Manavong,
from
Illinois. Grad student out of Kansas City, Missouri. Had a 13-8 last night. Illinois had a lot of career highs, none on the floor. We'll get to some of the other ones as we proceed through the night.
Beautifully executed front two and a half. Coach Ribeiro told me he's doing an upgrade tonight, planning on putting in a back three and a half twist. Oh, and it was supposed to be that right there.
Does not look great. Heartbreak City for Evan Manavong. So again, for the Big Ten Championships, it's podium. So it is a little springier, and we did see that to start the floor last night. And then it seemed like as the night went on, the athletes were adjusting.
That's right. It's certainly a different feel than what these athletes are used to in their training. You have a little bit more bounce from the floor. Sometimes those landings, you have to be more patient. You have to be tighter on the takeoff as well.
So that'll move us to Parker Thaxton, sophomore from New Jersey, who had a 14-05 last night to get in here. He was fantastic when Nebraska clinched the regular season title. Yes, Nebraska won, but Parker Thaxton was huge for the Buckeyes in that match at Covelli, which will be the home this year for the NCAA championships, which will be super exciting.
It certainly will be. Parker is the only athlete other than Brandon Dang for the Illini to have a start value in the 16s. And you see why in those first opening skills, full spins both directions. Very, very intricate work. This routine starts from a 16.0, which means he has a lot of difficulty packed into one routine. Dean, this has been clean so far. If he can get this dismount to a handstand, I think he's got a run for the championship there. Now, he did miss the pirouette on that dismount, so his start value will be down by about 3/10. He was supposed to go up to a handstand and pirouette. You see his shoulders really far over. That's still credit. That counts as a handstand, but he could not quite get the pirouette. So he's down 3/10 in start value, but that routine was so clean, he's making a great case for himself as a future Big Ten Pommel Horse champion.
Pretty sure we may have a new leader as we move back over to the rings. Asher Cohen had a 13.95 last night to qualify. He's a sophomore from Lakewood, Colorado.
Uprise planche. This skill called an Azarian roll to Iron Cross. Whenever you see athletes do that slow backwards roll between the rings, it increases the value of the ending strength position. Starts just 1/10 lower than Chris Reed. So the question is he cleaner than Chris? So far, I think so. I've seen very few execution errors in this routine. A stuck dismount would do him a lot of favors. 4.5 twisting double back. Same dismount as Chris Reed, does not get the stick. That's at least a 3/10 hop forward after that dismount. But I think the routine was cleaner. That's going to be close.
Wait and see on the score for Cohen. Luke James, also from Nebraska. He's a sophomore from South Africa, had a 13-8. The number still to beat, though, is Penn State's Artlip, who, what's he do? He starts out with a career high, 14.225, and that's a big number to look up at.
No better time to have a career high than at the Big Ten Championships, and he got it by sticking landings. That will be the difference maker on this event as we see Luke James getting started with his routine. And those are the hops that you don't want to give up. He was just a little impatient on that landing. One hop should have been enough to stabilize himself. Ends up taking a second. That was a big skill right there, though. Back 3.5 twist. This guy spins like a top. Combination work there, packing a lot of difficulty into one pass. Again, the most important pass to stick is the dismount. Can he get the bonus? Not quite. Probably only a 1/10 hop on that dismount, but to be fair, Dean, judging is typically a little bit more strict during the postseason. Let's take another look. Triple full three times around. Is that more than shoulder width? Right on the borderline. In a championship meet, that might well be a 3/10 deduction on that landing.
Halfway through the floor. Nice job, and a shout out for South Africa for Luke James. But it's still Penn State's Artlip in the lead as we move back over to the horse. Thaxton with a 14.525 as Sebastian Ingersoll, as you see, all of the Illini, five of them on the horse. Ingersoll at a 13-7. He's a senior from Chicago, 13-7 last night.
And Ingersoll is one of those athletes that refuses to fall. Oh, and I jinxed him. He's such a gritty guy. I've seen him hang on to pommel horse routines that would have knocked out most others. See if we can get a look at his hands. You saw his left elbow just buckled, and when that happens, there is very little that you can do. He looks a little bit tired here to me, Dean, as you see him struggling on that Russian travel skill right there. You know, last night's team finals, it takes so much out of you, the emotion, the fight. Whether you're winning or losing, there's so much emotion that's poured into it. It's tough to compete 2 days in a row like this, especially on an event like Pommel Horse.
See if he's got enough left in the engine just to get through it.
Nice triple Russian finish there for Ingersoll. Not what he was looking for, but as he scurries off the podium, he wants to get out of there.
There's Daniel Ribeiro in his second season as the top man. He's a great gymnast at Illinois. Ethan Boulder, also from Illinois, the senior from Knoxville, Tennessee, at a 13.95 last night. It's still Chris Reed in the lead as Boulder, the fifth of 10 to hit the rings here tonight.
And Boulder's routine starts from a 14-7 maximum possible score, so he needs to be almost perfect. that previous skill called a straight, straight body, straight arm press to handstand. Don't see many of those on the rings. Those skills right there, double fronts in between the rings. They're called Yamawakis. We'll see quite a few of those tonight. Remember, you are only allowed to do three strength skills in a row on rings before you have to break them up with a swing skill like those Yamawakis. Here's the dismount for a twisting double back, gets the stick. And he's fired up for it. Not enough difficulty to overtake Chris Reed, but a strong performance from Ethan Boder. Look at this dismount. Like a lawn dart.
The Lion Eye fired up just like they were last night. We're halfway through. We'll be back to finish up the floor, the horse, and the rings here in Champaign. July 13th, the BTN Big 10K returns to Soldier Field in Chicago for the fantastic 10K and 5K races and tailgate party. Scan the QR code or register right now at btnbig10k.com. State Farm Center, Champaign, Illinois. Evan Manabog had some ice. He had to leave early and get carried off the floor. Wish him well. So Connor McCool in the background. That's Cameron Nelson. You see the scores and the leaders right now. What a start for Michael Artlip after a really rough night for Penn State last night. Michael Artlip throws up his career high. The last time Penn State won the floor was Brandon Pantazis back in 2018. No more questions. Chad, watch this. So 6 years later, that's not to say that that score is going to hold, but well, you said it though, right when he hit it, you kind of felt like it was going to be tough to beat.
Absolutely. You can't stick four passes in a floor routine and not get a great score. That is one of the hardest things to do, is stick pass after pass consistently. Michael Artlip went out there and did it. He could very well be your leader.
Chuck Chimelka, top man for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. There's Randy Jepson, 33 years, folks. He's been the head coach. He's led his team to three national championships. Coach Shao, talked to him last night. Kurt Golder is here. He was here last night as well. It was good to talk to Kurt. And he had a big laugh because I told him, I'm like, you're like Benjamin Button. I mean, he looks like Daniel Ribeiro. Kurt Golder looks so young right now. As there's Daniel Ribeiro, the top man for the Illini. Of course, Kurt Golder, the former coach of the Michigan Wolverines, a man you know very well.
Absolutely. Coached that team for many, many years. Got quite a few Big Ten championships and a few NCAA championships.
Next on the floor, from Nebraska,
so here's Taylor Christopoulos, who in back-to-back years was runner-up to Fred Richard from Michigan. Taylor Christopoulos is coming back next year for one more season.
And take a look at this opening pass, double twisting, double layout. Big time gymnastics from Christopoulos. Most guys do that skill in the tucked position with their knees bent. Christopoulos does it in the layout straight body position. So, so difficult. There's that same double-double in touch position this time. He needs to be better on these landings. He has a high start value, 15.9. So he's got about 7/10 in difficulty over Artlip. But again, those landings are all important.
Taylor telling me earlier today that his mom and dad drive everywhere from Utah in kind of a souped up motor coach.
could really use a stick here. Hasn't stuck a single pass in this routine yet. Can he get one on the dismount? Almost, just a 1/10 hop on the dismount. It's a very, very difficult routine. I don't think it will be enough to overcome the execution that we saw from Art Lip. Take a look at this double twisting, double layout though. Big time gymnastics. Massive difficulty. Here's that dismount, triple full, maybe slightly under twisted as well. It's a good routine, but I don't think it's enough.
So getting ready on the pommel horse. I did talk to Will beforehand, and even though it looks very much like Hawk, it's pronounced Hauk, as he had a 14-2 last night, the senior from Indy.
And Dean, Will was the surprise of the night for me. Only a 15-2 start value, but he only had 1 point off in his execution deductions. That is unheard of on the pommel horse. He's so clean that despite the slightly lower start value, he has a genuine shot at overcoming Thaxton's 14-5-2-5.
Oh my goodness.
And we talked about it earlier, survival of the fittest, especially on an event like pommel horse.
Yeah, Lion Eye women's team. I talked to Mr. McCool for the Lion Eye men's team, and I said, hey, I saw you in Columbus when Ohio State and Illinois met on the Big Ten Network for the women. It's like, what made you do that? And he was sitting around with a couple of the other athletes. It was like 4-hour drive, you know, you lose an hour going there, picking up an hour back, and they did it in the same day.
Gymnastics is one big happy family, Dean. We got to stick together.
So that will not be enough to surpass Thaxton. If you're wondering about Ohio State, their last pommel horse Big Ten champ was the great Alec Yoder, who did it in 2019. He was pretty impressive. As we get ready now for Logan Myers on the rings, had a 14-1-5 last night.
And he'll need every bit of that 14-1-5 to overcome Chris Reed's 14-1. Not the most difficult routine, but he's capable of being very clean because of things like that. The level of precision that he holds those strength elements with is impeccable. You see most guys in the planter Maltese position, might be a few degrees high, or they might shake just a little bit. Not this guy.
See, his career best is a 14. He'll need to top that to catch Reed from Michigan.
Good form on that handstand, no wobbles. Just a little wobble there, only 1/10. Just the dismount left. Double twisting, double back, and the hop at the end. That'll be a 3/10 hop. I don't think it will be enough to overcome that 14-1 from Chris Reed, but that is about as good as you can execute a rings routine. Here's the dismount, double twisting, double tuck. You see he kept his hips behind him just a little bit. Put him off balance, had to take that slide back, but that's a great routine from Myers.
Here we go. Paul Judah. One of the all-time greats, and a man who's got a legitimate chance to be with the USA team in Paris this summer. Had a 14-7-5 last night. He's from Deerfield, Illinois, which is actually not very close to Champaign. It's almost 3.5 hours away.
Nice front double pike opening skill. This routine does start from a 15.9, same start value as Christopoulos. But he's going to have to do that right there. Stick the landings if he wants to catch Art Lip. Paul is one of those guys where I just love watching his gymnastics. Everything he does, from his landings to his form in the air to the non-acrobatic skills like this, even his corner transitions, just looks so polished and professional.
Yeah.
another one of those stuck landings. I've seen a few of those 3-10th hops, but he's had two stuck passes as well. If he can get a stuck dismount here, I think it's enough. Oh, just the one small step. 1/10th on the dismount. It's going to be close, Dean. Watch this flare sequence here. We'll see something very reminiscent of this on Pommel Horse later this rotation. Dismount one more time. Full twisting double back. And again, it looked like he was trying to stick. You can't try to stick. You just have to try to do a great dismount and let the stick happen.
First in the conference, first in the country, the freshman of the year from Illinois, Brandon Dang. And the fans, they know about Brandon Dang. They're fired up here.
And this is the matchup on Pommel Horse, Parker Thaxton versus Brandon Dang. He's doing a 16.5 start value routine, which, by the way, is the same start value that the last Illini Big Ten horse champion Ian Skirky had during his senior year, but Brandon's only a freshman. That skill right there, unbelievable. A three-quarter spin on one pommel directly into a flop sequence. So much difficulty in this routine. Can he hang on for the dismount up to the handstand pirouette? Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that will be your next Big Ten Pommel Horse champion. That was unbelievable. A little form on the way up to the handstand, but nothing too bad. And the level of difficulty in that routine, you just can't overcome it.
The Illini team, including the Illini women's gymnastics team, standing behind Daniel Ribeiro. So now we go to Rithik Puri, the brother of Akshay. He's a junior, a couple years older. Had a 14 last night to put himself in this position. Hoping to chase down his teammate Reed, who still has that 14-1.
Dean, I'm surprised. Rarely do you see the first man out during event finals hang on to that lead this far. Rithik's got a chance to take it away from his teammate Chris. Body planche, tough strength at the very end. You are absolutely exhausted by the time you get to this point in your routine.
You said it, Dang is the new leader on the Pommel Horse.
Just the dismount, full twisting double layout. He gets the stick. That will be a deduction for how low his chest went on the landing, but he was able to dig his toes in there and hang on and avoid the step. First time we've seen this dismount tonight, double layout with a full twist. You see the chest drop, but the feet don't move.
Little flex there. Big night on the rings for the Puri family. Here's Josh Carnes, big time talent. Fifth in the nation, had a 14.0
next up on
last night.
From Penn State, Josh Carnes.
And he, much like Paul Judah that we saw moments ago, does some fantastic flare work on the floor, has great form in the air as well. But he's got to stick those landings just like that. Big combination pass, front full to a double front to open things up.
Carnes, a junior from Erie, PA.
Three passes, three sticks. So far, so good. Watch this player sequence. Reminds me of the Oklahoma great Yul Muldaur. Competes for Team USA. Does a very similar construction in his floor routine to Josh here. Simple side pass, just a back layout, only a B value skill, but performs it with no deduction. Triple full, he stuck every pass but the dismount. Again, the dismount is the most important, but that was a very, very clean routine all the way through. Here's that triple full, one, two, three times around. Probably a 3/10 hop at the end there. That'll be a good score, but there's something about that stuck dismount, Dean. I don't know if it's gonna be enough. Remember, Artlip did stick his dismount and got that extra bonus 10th for doing so.
Cooper Giles, fifth in the country, a 14-2 last night. Cornhuskers eventually found themselves in third place last night.
And Cooper is a phenomenal pommel worker. You see the full spin on one arm to open things up. Good flop sequence there. This routine starts from a 15-6. So he has to be within 8/10 of deduction in order to catch Brandon Dang. That's tough to do on the pommel horse, but not impossible.
Cooper from the state of Illinois, Lake Zurich.
And that was a great routine. I don't think it will be enough simply because of the deficit in difficulty value. But look at how intricate this is. I keep saying it, there is no room for error on the pommel horse here. You get a good look at why. One of the better dismounts we've seen thus far tonight flies right up to that handstand. Very clean routine from Cooper Giles.
See the leaders still though. Artlip from Penn State on the floor. Dang, the rookie, Big Ten freshman of the year, leader of the horse at 14-8. And Curry, the new leader on the rings. As Nelson gets ready, no Donovan Hewitt in the rings. Last year he finished second to Anaya, who's won it in back-to-back years. He'll follow Nelson on the rings.
Next up on still rings from Ohio State, Cameron Nelson.
Cameron, one of those athletes that we're used to seeing on the floor exercise, really his standout event. Had a little trouble there last night, did not qualify for finals on that event, but credit where it's due on rings. He is a strong athlete on this event as well.
Senior from Jackson, Tennessee, 14-1 last night to get here.
And a pretty solid hold, but you saw right as he got to that strength position, his toes were a little bit low, had to correct. That is a deduction. That right there, though, very nice. Back uprise to an inverted cross. Don't see too many of those. That press to handstand at the end of those rings routines. It's a deceiving one. It looks easy. I promise it is not after some of those intense strength skills. Just the dismount. Double twisting, double back. Leaves his chest down a little bit. Has to take that big step forward. It's not going to be enough to overtake Curry, but a strong showing from Nelson. That dismount, two flips, two twists, count on, that's one and two. And you see him looking for the floor. He opened up out of that twist a little bit too early in an attempt to get that stick. Doesn't quite get there.
Connor McCool, he won this event last year, decided to come back one more year.
And we've talked about sticks all day long. McCool is the best in the business at sticking those landings. And he can really do a variety of things on this apparatus. You saw his opening pass in that highlight there was a 2.5 twisting double back. So he can flip, but then he also stuck his 3.5 twist. So he can twist as well. He's really a great all-around athlete on this exercise. There it is again, 2.5 twisting double back. Does not stick it this time, but massive, massive difficulty.
Connor McCool from Ocean City, New Jersey.
Good patience right there. Most athletes would take a step. He hangs on to it.
See his career high number there at 14-9.
This is so far so good. You see him doing a really interesting entry here into a lot of these passes. He acts like he's doing a round off at the last minute, turns his body the other direction for those front tumbling skills. Here's the dismount, triple full. Doesn't quite get it, but that might be enough. Remember, Michael Artlip starts from a 15-2. Connor McCool starts from a 15-7, so he's got about a half a point to play with here. Just a small hop on the dismount, only 1/10. Great routine from McCool.
Cool's teammate, as you're seeing what a night it was from Illinois, just fell short late as Michigan came back. As here we go, Ashton Anaya. My apologies, Preston Nye with a 14-0-5-0. Nye, a freshman from Elk Grove, California.
And that was a great recovery right there. Once your momentum is interrupted on this event, it's very difficult to get the speed of your swing back that you need to stay on. But he does a great job of working through that. Won't be enough to overtake his teammate Brandon Dang, but clean set.
We'll see a lot of Daniel Ribeiro here because it was McCool, then Nye, then next is Anaya, back-to-back champion on the rings, where Illinois has definitely been the lord of the rings at the Big Ten Championships. Ashton Anaya has won it the last couple years here, Brandon.
And he is lights out on this event. He's a great athlete because he can do those swing skills, those yamawakis, he can do solid dismounts, he sticks frequently, but this guy is freakishly strong.
Another former Lionized superstar, Alex Diab, won 4 straight ring titles. If Anaya can win this, Illinois will have won 7 of the last 8 ring titles at the Big Ten.
It's a very Alex Diab-esque Azarian to Maltese, and what a great view from our Big Ten camera crew right there. That skill, the second skill he did, called a butterfly, going all the way from a hang under the rings, lifting himself up into that planche position. Very rarely see that done even in Olympic level competitions. That's tough.
Look at his numbers there. 3rd in the NCAA, a career high of 14-8. We could see 3 eyes as the leaders when Anaya is done.
If he puts this dismount on his feet, I can guarantee it. Just a small slide back. Ladies and gentlemen, that should be your new leader on the still rings. Relatively simple dismount here, just a full twisting double back, C value dismount. That slide, probably a 3/10 slide, but the difficulty level of that routine is just stacked. And he knows it too. I guess when you're that strong, you can flex on camera every once in a while.
That was pretty intense. Last to go on the floor with a new leader, Connor McCool. He had that higher start value that helped him take the lead. Landon Blixt, sophomore for Michigan, had a 14-4-5 last night to qualify for tonight.
And that was actually a downgrade. He usually does a 2.5 twisting double back right there. Might be playing it safe in an attempt to get those stuck landings. And too hoppy on that landing there. That's an easy stick for a guy like Landon. Dean, we talked about in the open how Crew Bold for the Wolverines is one of those guys that on any other team, he would be the superstar. Landon is very, very similar in that regard. He's a senior national team member, really great all-arounder in his own right.
He's got a big number to chase down. Last year, Illinois swept all three of these as well, floor, horse, and rings.
Tell you what, Dean, he's got some sticky feet. There were a few mishaps earlier on, but if he can stick the dismount, this might be the difference maker, and he does! Landon Glickst, a stuck triple full dismount to end the night for the Wolverines on floor. Here's that combination pass, back two and a half to a front layout. And of course, watch it, one, two, three. And the level of patience on that landing. Paul in the background knows that's exactly what he needed.
Paul Judah was cheering on his teammate as he was getting ready to roll on the horse. And we do have three Illinois leaders here. Paul Judah, last to go on the horse. Grad student with a 14.05 last night to get here.
And he has a really beautiful and dynamic routine because of skills like this. He does almost the entire routine in a flared position. And that is tough. That skill is supposed to go up to a handstand, down, back, and then down into those flares one more time. And you saw him travel down and back across the horse a couple of additional times trying to regain his balance. You are allowed to do that, but couldn't quite catch his balance to bring it back inside the horse.
He and Fred Richard all season long have been on kind of a load management schedule.
And you have to be when you've got guys of this caliber who are training for the Paris Olympics. There's so many things going on in this Michigan gym any given week because of these two young men. A beautiful finish for Paul, graceful as always, but not able to get it done tonight.
So Paul Judah knows that it'll be Dang.
Next up on the still race from Penn State, Matthew Underhill.
So Matthew Underhill for Penn State had a 14.15 last night. He is last to go. We started with Michael Artlip at the floor, who hung up a pretty big score, but McCool caught him. I do want to let you know that Blix also had a 14.5, so looking at co-champs on the floor.
Underhill working through this routine nicely. He starts just a few tenths behind Ashton Anaya. Big 15.5 start value for this routine. A lot of strength packed in there. So far, not quite as clean as Ashton. He needs a strong finish here. Couple small steps on the landing. Strong showing from Matthew Underhill. A lot of strength in that routine. It won't be enough to surpass the Lord of the Rings, Ashton Anaya. Big dismount here, double twisting, double back. Just a couple shuffle steps there upon landing.
We got co-champs though on the floor. It's fitting that it's Michigan and Illinois based on how last night was. Connor McCool and Landon Blix, co-champs on the floor. Ashton Anaya will take home the rings for the third consecutive year. Paul Judah with an 11-9 as he obviously had to restart on the horse. Landon Blix has part of a little bit of history. Michigan has won the floor 14 previous times at the Big Ten Championships, last coming in 22 with Jacob Moore, and Landon Blix will share the title with Connor McCool.
And he did it in such a clutch fashion. Remember, if he doesn't stick that dismount, he does not get the co-championship alongside Connor McCool. That was the difference maker.
And Illinois has got a lot to celebrate as Brandon Dang, the Big Ten Freshman of the Year. There's Connor McCool, who will share that floor title. Dang will not share. He'll win outright the horse title. And Anaya in that huddle as well. Paul Judah will look to make his mark in Columbus at the national championships. And here's your top three, McCool and Blix tying with Artlip. Got to be proud of that 14-2-2-5. Dang, Thaxton, and Giles. Boy, thanks for really coming on strong, knowing that the NCAAs are going to be in Columbus. That is worth noting. And we are halfway through the event with three Illini winners. Michigan also getting in one. When we return, it's the vault, the P-bars, and the high bar. The Big Ten Men's Gymnastics Championships on the Big Ten Network is brought to you by Discover, the official credit card of the Big Ten Conference. Looking outside the State Farm Center here in Champaign, Illinois. And here are your first rotation winners, your Big Ten champs.
And we said during the open we would see some world-class gymnastics. We saw that on the floor exercise from both Connor and Landon. Stuck landings throughout. Brandon Dang is a freshman, 14.8. for the Illini, and of course, Ashton Anaya. We mentioned it yesterday, Dean, absolutely disrespectful to gravity. That rings routine is just unbelievable.
We're almost shocked that he had just a little tiny hop. It's still brilliant as Illinois continues their dominance on the rings. Both of the Diab brothers were here. And speaking of Illinois greats, Skirky is here as well. He won it last year.
That's right. What a great moment for young freshman Brandon Dang. I'm sure he looks up to Ian Skirky as an inspiration. And to have him witness that moment early on in his career is fantastic for him.
Skirky winning the horse last year. Before they start to warm up, let's take a look at who to watch here in this second rotation.
Well, Landon Blix is an obvious choice after capturing the co-championship on the floor exercise, but he is a heck of a vaulter as well. Stuck his vault yesterday. If he does it again tonight, he can certainly be in the mix. Josh Carnes on parallel bars, your defending Big Ten champion. Highest start value of the night on that event. He certainly can make a run for the championship tonight. And Evgeny Semenik on high bar, probably one of the cleanest high bar routines that you will ever see, not just in the Big Ten, but in the nation.
There's Mr. Blix, who's got one championship already. Can he get some more? We're going to take one more break and be back to start the second rotation. Welcome back to the State Farm Center as we get ready for the vault, the P-bars, and the high bar. Matthew Underhill will be the first of 10 to go on the vault. Last year's champion, Taylor Christopoulos from Nebraska, 22, it was Cameron Nelson. Underhill had a 14.55 to get here tonight.
And vault is very similar to floor exercise in that whoever sticks probably wins. 2.5 twist and a little off to the side. You saw it in his entry.
He had a little bit of a shoulder angle, so his body was not directly above the vault table. He was a little around the side, which led to him having to take that step out of bounds at the end there. As a reminder, out of bounds steps are additional deductions. 1/10 for 1 foot, 3/10 for both.
Move to P-bars. Caden Spencer had a 13.95. Fred Richard won the P-bars last year. Also was an NCAA champion. Josh Carnes got a piece of it. And Evgeny Semenyuk won it in 22. Caden Spencer for the Buckeyes.
And Caden does a lot of what we call long hang skills, just like that. Giant Diamandov right into a Bobzar that travel all the way from one end of the bars to another. Those long hang skills are any time that he passes through the bottom of the bars. Just a reminder, these athletes do not have grips on the parallel bars. Rings and high bar, you have a grip with a dowel to help you hang on. Parallel bars, no such thing. Dismount, double pike, step on the landing, but that's a clean way to get things started on the parallel bars for Caden.
Caden is a sophomore from Huntington, West Virginia.
Here's the dismount, double pike. We'll see a lot of those today. And again, you see him trying to stick. He keeps his chest down just a little bit, but just slightly under rotated, does have to take that step.
Sully Karsikas for Penn State, 13-6 last night.
Next up on high bar from Penn State, Sully Karsikas.
Karsikas, a freshman from Finland.
AK, as they call him, on the Nittany Lions squad. Big release move here. Coleman, full twisting, double back. Done pretty nicely. That's a good layout to Kajev right there as well. Criteria for that skill is as you pass over the bar, your hips have to be at a 180 degree angle, fully open. After you clear the top of the bar, you're allowed to lean forward to catch it. This has been clean so far, just the dismount, full twisting, double layout. Small hop on the landing. Good start, not the highest difficulty routine that we'll see this evening, but pretty clean all the way through. Would have loved to see a stuck dismount at the end, but it should be a pretty decent score.
As we move back to the vault, Kaizuki Hayashi really coming on strong late in the season for the Buckeyes. The senior from Fairfax, Virginia was so good in that matchup against Nebraska. Chuck Chmielka's team did win, but Hayashi, one of several career highs that night. There were 19 between the two teams.
You see the Letterman jacket there, keeping him warm as he waits to complete this vault. Again, I can almost promise you that whoever wins this event will stick the landing. He's got a big vault here. Oh, and you saw him go for the stick. He put his feet out in front of him a little bit. Had to scramble backwards to stay on his feet, but beautiful form in the air. Watch as he takes off of the table. Knees straight, legs together, gorgeous form. Just had his feet out in front a little too far to stick.
We'll get that jacket back as Taylor Christopoulos had a 14 flat to qualify. As I mentioned, his mom and dad are here. He's also got an older brother, Tony, his sister, Taylor. He's got two twins, Tina and Tia. Big family in Utah.
Taylor has a pretty difficult routine here. One skill in particular, I'll call it out when he does it. That was a good peach handstand to start things off. We'd like to see him keep his arms straight. Here's that skill. It's called a Makuts. Nicely done. The criteria on that is you cannot pause on that one bar in between those upward and downward elements of that skill. And that's an upgrade right there. Diamandov, 1.25. Intricate stuff from Christopoulos. Small hop on the landing, but that's a great set for him. Upgraded difficulty as well. And that is such a great angle of the intricacy of that skill right into the regular Diamandov. That is a lot going on one arm on those bars, 6 or 7 feet up in the air. That's tough.
Sebastian Ingersoll, 13-7 for the Lion-Eye last night to qualify.
He's got a lower start value here. He did a 14-8 routine last night, start value that is. So he has to be clean. He's got some connected Tkachevs here. Back to back, he will receive bonus points for connecting those two release elements. Full spin on one arm, that element called a Zoli Min. Really tests your grip strength, especially late in a routine like that. Just the dismount left, double twisting, double back, gets the stick. That is tough gymnastics at the end of that routine. It's only one more twist than the half in, half out, or full twisting double out that we're accustomed to seeing on high bar, but I promise it makes it that much more difficult to find the landing. No problem for Ingersoll.
Beautiful landing for Ingersoll. We will have a new high bar champion, as last year's champion Fred Richard electing to sit out tonight, part of that load balance that we often talk about. Here's Michael Artlip, 14-5-5. Of course, Michael Artlip had a great start to the night on the floor.
That great start by sticking landings. We'll see if he can do the same thing on this event. Same vault that we've seen from everyone else so far. Oh, he made a liar out of me. It's a Yurchenko, still a 2.5 twist. He does it from the Yurchenko, meaning he does a round off onto the springboard, back handspring onto the table. Traditionally a little bit easier to stay clean. Let's take a look right there. Maybe a little bit of soft knees in the air. Nothing too bad, but again, big three-step slide back with his left foot. Doors still open for somebody to stick a vault.
Jacob Murray next to go on the P-bars for Ohio State. Had a 14 last night to get here. You see the number to beat is his teammate, Caden Spencer, at a 14.05.
Jacob only starts from around a 15, but his superpower is how clean and consistent he can be. There's that Makuts skill again. Done well. See his lines and the handstand. Oh, and that was a mistake. That Stutz traveled all the way from the middle of the bars down towards the end. That skill is really supposed to stay in one spot on the bars. Not a disaster, but will be some deductions for not quite reaching the handstand. But that is how you finish a parallel bar routine. Double front to an easy stuck dismount. Here's that Stutz handstand one more time. You see how he never quite gets up to the handstand position. He'll receive credit for the skill, but some deductions on that swing as well. He needs to stay straight body. So not everything he's capable of, but still a decent score.
Parker Thaxton, another Buckeye on the rise, 13-6-5 last night.
And Dean, rarely do you see somebody who is this good at pommel horse also make a high bar final. Usually, if you're starting in the 16s on horse, you're a horse specialist, but Parker can do it all.
Sophomore from Robbinsville, New Jersey, Parker Thaxton.
That angle there on the half tock, a little flat. We'll talk about it over and over tonight. Angles are so important on high bar. All of the pirouetting elements need to finish in a handstand. That one, solid. Full spin over the bar. And it's the full twist and double out again. Gets the stick. Lower difficulty routine. I don't anticipate it will be enough to get on the podium, but executed pretty cleanly and a lot to build off of going into NCAA championships in a few weeks.
Chase Mondi, 14-4-5 last night.
You see Michael Artlett, the 14-3-7-5. That Yurchenko vault paying off for him, taking the lead on this event. Can Chase Mondi take it back from him? It'll be close. That was a clean vault. Very good form in the air, but again, 3-10th, pretty big hop coming out of it. You see that pre-flight going from the springboard to the table, that leg separation there, that is traditionally why, right there, you see it coming up onto the table. That's why those Yurchenko style vaults typically score better than this, which is called a Kazematsu.
Casper Garnzarek, 13-9-5. Garnzarek last night, 13-9-5. Ohio State Spencer, the leader right now with a 14-0-5.
Casper starting from around a 15-1. Needs to be very clean on this routine to be in the running. That was a good Healy right there. You see a lot of guys do that skill. He catches it pretty early, which is exactly what you want to see. Oh, and right there you saw he didn't quite swing up high enough into that handstand before initiating the spin for that Diamandov. Has to take a couple of steps with his hands out of it. And again, under-rotated on the Stutz there.
His teammate Josh Carnes, your reigning P-Bar champ, he'll be last to go tonight.
Not a bad routine from Casper Gonzarek. Not what he's capable of, though. You saw a couple angles that he didn't quite hit handstand on.
Evgeny Semenyuk, 14-1 last night to get here.
And this was one of our athletes to watch in this rotation. He has one of the cleanest high bar routines that you will ever see, both in his releases, but especially in those pirouetting elements. We talked about handstands, how important they are. Watch Evgeny with those angles.
See Mondi and Artlip tied on the vault.
That is what Evgeny does best. Half talk right to a handstand, avoiding the angle deduction that so many athletes receive on this event. Great job on those pirouetting elements. These are called German giants. I call them shoulder killers, but Dakota Points calls them German giants. Just the dismount, half in, half out. He gets the stick. That might be your new high bar leader. Dean, there's just not much deduction you can take on a routine like that. Here's the dismount. High flying. Half twist on the first flip, half twist on the second. We call it a half in, half out. He's looking at the ground the whole time and easily gets the stick.
And might steal some thunder from the Buckeyes' Parker Thaxton, who in back-to-back nights had set career highs. Mari Sewell, 14-8 yesterday for the Illini.
And Amari flies high on this event. His amplitude is what makes him stand out from the competition. Watch how high he gets off this ball table. And that right there is what we've been waiting for all night long. Massive amplitude, good form in the air, and a stuck landing. Amari Sewell for the Illini will certainly take the lead after that. He just launches himself off the table, great distance away from the table as well. Believe it or not, that's something the judges are looking for. How much height and how much distance do you get off the table?
And well knows deserved. It. Yeah. The junior from Bowie, Maryland. He was way, way up there, Brandon. Michael Giroux, 14-1 last night for Penn State. Giroux, a senior from Northville, Michigan.
And I think Michael Giroux has some of the best lines on this event. Consistency has been a thorn in his side all season. But even the handstand position, just beautiful straight lines. Effortless peach to handstand. Giant Diamandov, beautiful one. Oh, and just overshot the Stutz handstand right there. What I love about Giroux is that he kind of lives on the edge on this event. And it's either perfect or it's a little too much. Double pike dismount. Has to take the big step forward. Not what he's capable of. Will not be enough to overcome Spencer. But so much potential in that routine. If he's on, he can absolutely contend for a title, not just here, but also at NCAAs.
So he'll get some love as Kazuki Hayashi, once again with his varsity jacket, had a 13-7 last night on the high bar. Meanwhile, you see Sewell, the new leader, 14-8-2-5. Sewell has four of the top seven scores in Illinois history as Hayashi up on the high bar for the Buckeyes.
And this is an exciting routine. Hayashi does not hold back. He is aggressive on this event. Watch the tap, the body shape changes that he does to bounce the bar and give him extra height. Right there. And it just launches him into the air. Beautiful Kovac style release. But he's not done. Here's a Tkachev. And he's got another one right here. Two connected back to back. Just jam-packed with difficulty. Wow. And the stuck dismount from Hayashi. My goodness, we got a battle over here on high bar.
There's a lot in that routine.
Here's the first couple release moves. Full twisting double back over a steel bar 9 feet up in the air. Not exactly on my to-do list. Doesn't seem to bother Hayashi one bit. Here's superstar Donovan Hewitt cheering on his teammate from the sidelines.
Hayashi getting hot at the right time. We'll be back to update you on the leaders with more vault, P-bars, and high bar here in Champaign. Stay with us on the Big Ten Network. Big Ten Plus delivers thousands of non-televised live events, access to next-day on-demand replays, multi-view to watch up to four games at once, and a 24/7 channel for your favorite school. There's no plus like home. Subscribe and stream for as low as $9.95 a month at BigTenPlus.com. A great big view of State Farm Center. Halfway through, we'll take a look at the leaders. Amari Sewell with a 14-8-2-5 for the Lion-Eye on the vault. P-Bar's Caden Spencer for the Buckeyes. And on the high bar, Michigan Wolverines, Evgeny Semyonik. And last year's high bar winner was this man right here, Fred Richard, who was the NCAA and Big Ten all-around champion. He went back-to-back. Congratulations, by the way, Fred Richard, on winning the team title and the all-around title last night. I know you wanted to compete in the high bar, but you're looking forward to being in Columbus for the national championships, I'm sure.
Number one, thank you for having me, Dean. But, yeah, I mean, we're looking for NCs coming up, preserving the body, making sure I peak on that day, and... Yeah, so I'm sitting up. I'm with you guys today. I'm a commentator. I guess I got this job earlier than I thought. So we're gonna enjoy it today. So
you always have fun. That's kind of part of who you are, I would say.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, I think that's how I grew up in my gym. Just, you know, with my teammates, just always having fun, challenging each other, and just not taking it personally. You know, like, we come here to have fun. So that's what I'm doing.
And I'm sure you're going to have some fun with us here tonight. Correct me if I'm wrong, but aren't you studying in film production and a lot of what we're doing here?
Exactly, I am. And so I just love seeing behind the scenes since I get involved with it. And I'm looking to go more of the TV, movie production route, but still fun doing commentating stuff, doing all things in content creation. So, yeah.
It's interesting, Fred, that the runner-up the last 2 years has been Taylor Christopoulos to you. Great competitor, and Taylor Christopoulos got here with a 14-6. He won this competition last year.
He definitely can do it again. It's going to be interesting. I mean, he's got great power. You're going to see this, and it's pretty clean. So
he's going to have to stick. We said it all night long.
Oh,
a stick
right
will
there.
Be a win. Oh, so close. Just that 1/10 hop on the landing.
Exactly, yeah, but super clean in the air. I think the score will be pretty solid. See this. Look at that form. I think that he's probably got one of the best forms on this vault. I am looking at this form. It looks amazing. Wow.
Fred Richard joining the broadcast booth alongside Brandon Burns. I'm Dean Linke. That's Taylor Christopoulos, who just finished up. It'll be Crew Bold up next on the P-Bars.
Oh, yeah.
14-6. And, you know, one of the things that Brandon Burns said in the open, he said on any other team, Crew Bold would be the superstar, but when you got Fred Richard and Paul Judah, it's hard. But Crew Bold is legit.
He is legit. Crew is a dog. That's how I'm going to describe him. I think you're going to see in this routine, he's focused, he's going hard today. I think he come out with a medal, so let's see.
He packs a lot of difficulty into this routine. You see right there, peach half to open things up. Back to back with the peach to a handstand. Great form on this,
wow,
too.
Yes, I think, wow, everything is super solid so far. He's really going for it. Today on P-Bars, I think you're going to need a stuck dismount if you want to win this. I think it's going to be very tight competitors, so let's see if he can put it down.
Does have a high start value, starting from around a 15.7 maximum possible score. Here's
down,
that
Drew.
Dismount you were talking about, Fred.
I knew he was going to do it. Come on. He's a dog. I said it. I said it from the beginning. That's Crew. Crew Bold. He's bold.
The grad student from Delray Beach, Florida. That, I think, is going to be your new leader, Brandon.
He should be after a dismount like this. Double front. And you see the reaction immediately. He knew it as soon as his feet hit the ground.
Love to see that. I mean, Michigan's not playing around today. It's going to be an interesting last three events. He looks really happy, so that's great.
So well done, Crew Bold. Max Odden for Nebraska had a 13-7 to make it to tonight's high bar. Of course, the high bar was won by the man sitting right next to me, Fred Richard, a year ago.
Yeah. I'm a retired high bar specialist, though.
Retired just for the day, right?
For the day, and then back to it. Max is a very clean gymnast. He's younger than me, so I think he's a freshman. But, I mean, he was pretty high level as a junior, and he's going to show probably some very clean gymnastics tonight.
He's got some big skills like that Kovacs right there, too. You know something about that, Fred.
Oh, I do, and that's not an easy skill to catch.
You're right, Fred. He is a freshman from Arizona.
looking very good so far. I think he's going to need a stick for this. Can he put it down? It's going to be a tight one. I think he needed a stick.
Almost got the stick. It's a big dismount, double twisting, double back, two flips, two twists in a laid out position. And you see him spotting the floor there, trying to fight for that stick, but couldn't quite hold on to it.
Also an awkward landing. You know, you're on the edge of the mat and you gotta step right off the mat. But
Crew Bold, the new leader on P-bars, yes, as we move back over to the vault. And Cameron Nelson, who won this in 2022, let's take a look at his win a couple years ago.
And Cameron is one of those athletes that just has so much power. Unique vault, it's a front handspring, double twist. Most guys you'll see do that Kazumatsu style or your Chinko style vault. Cameron, the only one doing that handspring double twist in tonight's competition, but clearly he's capable of big scores with that vault.
He's got a little Fred Richard flair in him too.
He's got some flair, and I haven't been watching him too much because I'm competing at the same time, but every time I see him do this vault, he sticks it. So see if he has it today.
He has been consistent all season long. Can he do it again tonight at the Big Ten Championships?
Oh, he tried to hide it. I don't think he played it off, though. That was really clean.
He needed to be just a little more convincing. It was close.
That's funny.
Handspring double twist. Can he hold on to it? What do you think, Fred?
I don't think they gave it to him. Look at his coach's reaction. It's pretty funny. Suarez, his hands on his head. He's like,
just hold it, right?
Yeah. So close.
So clean.
To be fair, he knew that he had to stick, so he was trying to sell it no matter what.
I love those situations, though, when you're right. You know you can't really stick it, but you're trying, like, how do I, like, make it look like a stick? How do I smoothly transition?
So here comes Will Hauk, 14-2 last night to get here. Eighth in the country.
Coach Daniel Ribeiro told us he would be adding a Bobzar in the middle of this routine, upgrading his difficulty a little bit. Last night only had 7/10 off of this routine.
This
unbelievably clean.
Amazing, yeah. I can just see it by like the handstand line, the toe point. Oh, that's going to be some deduction.
Don't want to give away any tenths on the simple stuff. There's that Bobzar, the upgrade.
Three-man booth here, Brandon Burns, Fred Richard, the Michigan superstar, joining us to round out the night. Dean Lincoln just along for the ride.
All right, he's gonna need a stick again. Ooh. Yeah, not a win. I think it was a great routine, but some small errors here and there. So we'll see where that lands.
He would have needed to be almost perfect with his execution. Cutting it a little close there to the bars on that dismount.
And it's interesting because, I mean, if you get too close, you hit the bar. Like, I have some teammates that, you know, were in meet and your elbow hits the bar. And it's a 5/10 deduction. It's a big deduction, but you played it off well.
As we get ready for your teammate, Robert Knoll, what can you tell us about Robert?
Robert, he's a competitor. I think he loves, like, the thrill of competition. He's going to be trying a new skill today, Coleman, adding that in, which he didn't do in qualifications. So let's see if he can do it. Let's go, Rob.
Big Ten Championship event finals. Go big or go home. Adding in the upgrade.
Nice. This will be a layout to Kotchev. Should be pretty clean. Nice. All right, let's see if he's going to go. Do it. Come on, Rob. On the bar.
He's going for it.
Yeah.
Right, looks like he looks like he's been doing that for a long time.
I know, right? I mean, he loves competition. I think he's someone who thrives under pressure, and I think he can put a stick down for the end of this routine, so let's see. Clean.
Beautiful angle on that jam handstand. Fred, the only thing that Rob was missing last night was the stuck dismount. Does he get it tonight?
You better stick it, Rob. Let's go. Stick. I'm gonna beat him up over that. If he loses by a 10th, I'm going to be mad at him.
As we see the Michigan fans, Fred, and we take a look at the tight hands and the finish, tell us why you chose Michigan.
Yeah, I think, so when it came to choosing a college, I was looking at two things. Of course, as high-level academics, and then, of course, high-level gymnastics. I wanted to pick a place with, like, very good school program that could set me up for whatever I want to do career-wise. And in the film TV world, they have a great program. And then when it came to the gymnastics team, I mean, the culture was amazing on my visit. And I saw the gymnastics these guys were doing. It was high level. And I also, one small thing is I wanted to choose a team that was not already winning. I wanted to help get a team to national championships. And Michigan fit that.
Well said. Preston Nye from Illinois had a 14-9 to qualify for tonight. He'll be trying to chase down his teammate Sewell, still the leader at 14-8-2-5.
See it.
He needs a stick here, clean in the air. Oh, and unfortunately, just that hop to the side. He keeps it in bounds, but no stick will probably mean not enough.
Yeah, for it's the clean, win. But today's a stick game. In these finals, it's close. You need to stick to win. Right there, and he's on the line a little bit, but I don't think the line judge said anything.
As a reminder, on the line is in, over the line will incur additional deductions, similar to the floor exercise and the out of bounds rules over there.
Michael Fletcher, I've known Michael since I was probably about 10 years old from my region, so it's fun to see him competing out here, and let's see if he's got it.
Came back for his sixth year, 14-1 to get here. The man has overcome so much. He told me earlier today he's fully recovered from that torn labrum, but his rotator cuff is like 90% shot.
And parallel bars is not the event that you want to be on with a bad rotator cuff, as we see him do a beautifully executed giant Diamandov right there. But just speaking with head coach Ribeiro, he said that Mike's determination and dedication just means so much to him. He's really an energy center for the team.
Very clean set. I mean, we didn't have the stick, but overall, I didn't see much deduction. I think that was very well executed. Nice job, Mike.
We'll stick with Michael's. Michael Giroux, Penn State, 13-8 to get here last night.
Next up on
high bar
from Penn State, Michael
Giroux. Let's see it, Mike. And Mike is another gymnast who, outside of the gym, is also trying to promote the sport. I mean, he's built a big following on social media also, millions. And I looked up to him when I was looking to build a following. Let's see this.
He's got some big release moves starting right here. The Cassina, full twisting double layout. He's not done. Coleman,
fingertips.
That was just barely back to the bar. That's about as close as you can cut it.
The beauty of it is, like, fingertips is scary, but it's no deduction. So far, it's a very clean sail. Nice. I mean, he's really got a shot at this. If he can put down a clean dismount, I think he's definitely contending for medals, maybe first place.
Good angles so far. You said it, Fred. We need a stuck dismount. Double twisting, double layout. He gets the stick.
He wanted it today. He might have gotten it. He needs to beat a 14-1 by my teammate, Genny.
Let's take another look. High-flying stuff. Break it down for us, Fred.
Oh, yeah, he's floating. Form is perfect. And he fought for it, too. A little, like, uneven feet, like footing right there, but no deduction, I think, and very clean.
That hug says it all, because he has had to overcome a ton of injuries as well in his career. Big hug from Randy Jepson. As you see Paul Judah, like our special guest here, the amazing Fred Richard, hopes to be in Paris for the Olympic Games. How cool would that be to have both of you there?
It would be amazing, and I think we're gunning really hard for this opportunity. I think you guys are about to see the cleanest vault in men's gymnastics. Paul's form is immaculate. I don't even know how to describe it. I look up to it every day in the gym. No deductions. I can't find deductions.
Woo!
form was perfect, just needed the stick. I think it's going to be very tight.
Fred, I don't know what you think, but I don't see any deductions other than the hop on the landing.
I know. I honestly feel like these judges are like, they feel bad about giving perfect scores, so they look for something. Yeah, he had the 3/10 hop, but I don't know where else the deduction comes from. The toes are pointed, the legs are together. I see just a hop.
To me, that is a 14.9 vault, 15.2 start value, 3/10 for the hop. That's it. I don't see anything else wrong with that.
Now, they'll probably find a tether two, I think. Either they'll say lack of height or lack of preparation. Some of these small things, but it was amazing. Well,
another Wolverine, Evgeny Semenyuk, who leads in the high bar. Now trying to show his stuff on the P bars.
See, I get to train with Genny every day, and I know Genny is a perfectionist. He doesn't just try to get skills. He tries to master them, does hundreds of them until it's perfect. So I wouldn't be surprised if this routine comes out perfect.
He won this event in 2022, Fred.
Mm-hmm. He's looking really clean so far. Okay. Nice.
Just effortless on those peach elements. Flies up to the handstand.
All right, fly high Genny on this skill. This is called a Bobzar. Nice. Oh, he's definitely contending today. I mean, he's going to have to finish very clean. Let's see this. Smooth. He has two skills left, but the dismount is going to be the decider again.
His handstands have been fantastic, Fred.
It's perfect. I told you, perfectionist. You better stick this, Genny. Let's go. Come on. Woo. It's going to be a 3/10 hop. I think that was an amazing routine. He does have a pretty strong start. So beating a 14.5 is definitely possible. It's going to be a close one, though. Wow. He still has some, like, a lot of room on that. He opened a little bit and still took a big hop. I got to tell him to kick out more.
New leader on high bar is Michael Giroux, and it's a Wolverine, Crew Bode, who is ready to try to overtake Giroux. Michael Giroux, the leader right now, passing your teammate Evgeny.
Yeah. This is so fun to watch. I know he can do this, and let's see if he's ready to take this dub today. I mean, he's got the highest releases. You're going to see so much hype from his first skill. Let's go, Crew.
Crew does not hold back on releases like
that.
The Casina, he is nowhere near done, though. There's the Coleman.
All right, he's two in. These ones have to be the perfect form. Yup. Oh, he wants it today. Yes. Crew's going to have probably one of the highest difficulties on high bar today, so he's got some room. But, I mean, he's still going to have to execute to basic perfection. Yes.
5-5 start value, 3/10 higher than Giroux.
Oh, another form deduction. He's going to have to stick if he wants this.
Big break there, at least 3/10 with the legs. Can he stick?
I think you did it. Crew, I think you did it. I think you did it. Let's go. That's what we're talking about. Two events. First place on parallel bars, and I think high bar two.
Fred, you're one of the only other people in this arena that can do these same release moves. Break down what we're looking at here.
Yeah, the first skill you're looking at is a Casina. It's a rank G, which is a very high-ranking difficulty skill on high bar. And then there's the Coleman and then the Dukachevs. I mean, they're very hard to do. It's very easy to miss the bar. All right.
Last to go on the vault, Landon Blixt, who had a 15 last night.
Yes.
This young man's really coming on strong as well, Fred.
He is. I mean, Landon's my age. He works super hard in the gym. I know he's able to stick this again today. Stuck it in the qualifying, so let's see if he got it. I think he's one of the best vaulters I know, if I'm being honest.
If he can do what he did last night, he would be your winner.
Come on, Landon.
He's going to need a stick.
Yup. He was definitely going for the stick. It's a form of sticking, not the form we wanted. It was so, he was going for perfect form. He was going for controlled stick landing. I think that's the way to go out. I think on our team, we really like pride ourselves on going big and going all out.
Best in the country on this event, Josh Carnes. number one in the country, won it last year, 2023, at a 15-1 last night.
Yeah, he beat me last night. Josh is amazing on parallel bars, super clean, and really consistent. I honestly wouldn't be surprised if he throws a 15 up again.
And he has the highest start value of anyone competing on the parallel bars tonight, starting from a 16-1.
Oh, that's going to be a big deduction. Over 5/10 deduction, so it's close to a fall. He's going to have to do basically the rest of the perfection to have even a chance. But watch this next skill coming. Highest bobs are you've ever seen. It looks so easy.
Just floats over the bars, doesn't he?
I gotta like text Josh after and ask him to teach me how to do that. Nice.
Yeah. Big dismount.
Ooh. A lot of deductions on the routine. I don't think he has it.
I feel like your teammate Bold may have enough. What do you think, Brandon?
I think he's gonna hold on to it. It's a big score from Bold, and Josh does not capitalize here as he could have. If he had stuck that dismount, maybe, but there's just too many deductions in that routine for him to overtake Crew.
Last gymnast of the evening, Taylor Christopoulos, had a 14 last night. And Fred, just so you know, I asked him about being the runner-up to you at the Big Tens the last 2 years and even at the NCAAs, and he had a really classy answer. He's like, Fred Richards, one of the best gymnasts we've ever seen. I take a lot of pride in being runner-up to him.
That's pretty nice to say. I mean, Taylor's amazing. I think everybody in the community has watched him just grow and get better and better. And I mean, being second is definitely not something to be disappointed about.
Woo!
That was close. Wow.
He is coming back next year.
So that'll be his fifth year. Yep. That's going to be awesome to see. Yes. Got one more. I mean, he's in the contending right now for a medal, so if he puts this down. Ooh, it's a big hop. I don't think that takes Michael Jerome. But this, very clean kick out. I mean, to be able to do that really shows that you've mastered the skill. And this is really high, just over rotates it a little bit.
Fred Richard, want to thank you so much for being with us. Want to wish you the best of luck in the NCAAs, bring it home again, an all-around title. Congrats on winning the all-around. Fred Richard, the man, with us here.
Thank you guys for having me. I got to say, like, congratulations to everybody competing. I didn't compete today, but I know how hard it is to do 2 days back-to-back, and some guys really showed up today, so respect all you guys. And, of course, go Blue.
Respect to you, Fred.
Yeah.
Thank you, boys. Good luck in the NCAAs. Fred Richard. We'll be back to wrap things up and crown the champions, including Mr. Sewell. Stay with us on the Big Ten Network. There's one right in front of you. Tomorrow, don't miss Men's Lacrosse when the Wolverines host the Scarlet Knights. Live coverage begins at 7 Eastern only on the Big Ten Network and the Fox Sports app. State Farm Center, Amari Sewell for the Illini, your host, with a 14.825, a stuck landing. He is your Big Ten vault champion on the P-Bar's Crew Bold. He has been coming on strong. We've been talking about that a lot all season long, and Crew Bold gets it done with a 14.55 on the P-Bar's and the high bar winner. How about Michael Giroux sticking with it, and he brought the heat, 14.225. Rough night yesterday for Penn State. Great night tonight for the Nittany Lions, including Michael Giroux. Fred Richard talking about how Michael Giroux has worked so hard to promote men's gymnastics. And Fred Richard also doing the same thing. Fred's teammates, Evgeny Simonyuk and Crew Bold. Second and third, Taylor Christopoulos will also tie for third. Here are all of our individual champions. We had a tie on the floor, Connor McCool goes back-to-back. Landon Blixt, from the Michigan Wolverines also gets a share of the title on the floor. The freshman of the year, Brandon Dang. Was he beautiful or what on the horse? He'll take it down with a 14-8. Ashton Anaya, back-to-back-to-back rings champions at 14-2. And the Lion Eye keep it going on the vault with Amari Sewell, as we just told you. Crew Bold on the P-bars and Michael Giroux. Let's send it down to Brandon Burns, who's with all of our winners.
Thanks, Dean. I'm here with our Big Ten champs, starting with our floor champion, Landon Blixt. Co-champion, rather. Landon, you knew that you had to stick that dismount, and you had a clutch performance. Walk us through that experience.
So I turned the corner to my last dismount, and I was like, okay, I got to put this to my feet if I want to get a medal here. So, you know, I just kind of, like, did whatever I could to kind of, like, slide back into that stick. So I'm super proud. Thank you very much.
Well, congratulations on a great performance. Connor McCool, you go back-to-back on this event. You won it last year away, this year at home. How does this one compare?
Yeah, this is the exact kind of moment you think about when you say you're going to come back for a fifth year, right? To, like, win a title like this at home with, you know, the next three Illini you're going to talk to. Like, this is the most special night ever. It's just so exciting.
Congratulations on a great performance. Can't wait to watch you at NCAAs. Brandon Dang, the phenom freshman on pommel horse, a 16-5 start value on the toughest event. How do you handle that kind of pressure?
I think it's kind of in, like, the work that we do in the practice, like making sure that what we do physically and mentally kind of carries over to, like, the big stage when we actually go to compete.
Congratulations, another fantastic performance, and I'm sure we'll see you fighting for an NCAA title as well. Here with the Lord of the Rings, Ashton Anaya, you went back to back to back. How do you sustain that kind of performance year over year?
Just consistency in and outside of the gym, you know, trying to do the same thing, and I really wanted it, and so I worked really hard the whole year, and it worked out. So,
going to see the same thing at NCs?
I really hope so.
Well, congratulations on another title. Amari Sewell, you knew you had to stick. What was going through your mind as you were preparing to do that vault?
I was just prepared to do a good vault with almost zero pre-flight, zero in-air, and hopefully I land well enough to give me a good score. If the stick came, then it came. If it didn't, then, you know, the efforts that I put in would hopefully lead me there anyway.
Well, the stick came indeed. Congratulations on a great vault and a great performance. We got some co-champions on the high bar crew after the fight last night for this Michigan team. How great does it feel to get a share of this event title?
Oh my gosh, it's obviously amazing. So much fun, so much adrenaline, so much just a lot of fun being out there. And, you know, it just feels good that the work that you put in actually is paying off. And I've spent so much time with form. I've had the higher level skills for a while, but been spending a lot of time this year on form. And it just came together at the right time. Stick came right there, and, you know, that's what it takes, I guess. So,
came together, it did. Congratulations, crew. Michael Giroux, you've battled so many injuries. What's this one mean for you?
Honestly, man, the injuries pointed me to God, and I prayed for this one. I prayed to be shown the path to becoming a Big Ten champion, and I was in my head a lot in the beginning, and then at the end I remembered I prayed for that and that I was just going to hit the set, and I did it. So I'm really proud, and, you know, all the glory to God. So,
congratulations. A lot to be proud of. And congratulations to all of our Big Ten champions here. Dean, back to you.
All right. Well done, Brandon, and well done to all of the champions. We'll be back to wrap it up from Illinois. The Big Ten Men's Gymnastics Championships closing it out in Champaign. Get all the news and highlights from around the conference on the Big Show tonight at 11 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network, where they will be talking about tonight's champions, six event champions. A couple were shared as well. That's how good the Big Ten is as we start to walk our way toward the NCAAs. Once again, here are the individual champions sharing the title on the floor. Connor McCool wins it again, along with the youngster Landon Blix from Michigan. The freshman of the year, Brandon Dang, takes home the horse. Anaya, 3 years in a row, the Lord of the Rings. Amari Sewell, beautiful stuck vault. Michael Giroux on the high bar, and Crew Bold on the P bars. Breaking news, Fred Richard, who was part of the broadcast team tonight, your gymnast of the championships, back-to-back winner. And of course, Coach Shao, Coach of the Year. And Fred Richard, by the way, also the Big Ten Gymnast of the Year, announced earlier.
And he deserves every bit of credit. So does this man right here, Yuan Shao, and a great job with this Michigan program.
All right, two fantastic days here in Champaign. That's going to wrap it up for the 2024 Big Ten Men's Gymnastics Championships. Michigan, your team champ, Fred Richard, your all-around champion. You just saw your event winners. For Brandon Burns, I'm Dean Linke saying good night from Champaign. Coming up, it's Big Live Basketball post-game press conference.